Wind's good.
What are the factors we have here to work with? Wind?
Wind, yep.
Yeah.
Water?
Right.
Terrain, again.
Terrain?
Wind.
Okay. We don't have a lot of terrain necessarily that's going to affect all this, but we do have some cover that we can work with. So yesterday, Matt and I came out here and what we sort of decided on, I'll go ahead, Matt, is our first bird will be this one group over here that mentioned we'll have a bird come up from behind the tall grass, sort of a little bit of an angle, but back along the grass. That's going to put that piece of cover in play. You know, that's that'll be a, like a little wall there. From behind the trees over here, our shot flyer, getting it out of the way. We're going to come back out into the field. We're going to go back across to the second point, just at the right edge of the cover. Put a hole in blind. It's going to throw one at a pretty good angle back up in the green grass. So we're putting a re-entry in play on that mark. On the way back from your last bird, there's going to be a diversion bird right here that's going to plop out right here in the grass in front of us. You're going to know off of it because we think one of these birds over here was wounded. We know this one's dead. You've got two blinds. We're going to have you pick up this short blind. You see the piece of ribbon. Mm-hmm. You come back and you can get your diversion bird. And then the second blind is across the point to the second piece of water or second piece of land. Again, you see our ribbon. Questions? Thoughts? Comments? That gives a break. It's not as mean as in line on both fingers. that's meaty. That's good.
I'll load the live flyer for the guys who are shooting.
Okay. Again, it'll be over here. So we'll need a station here for our diversion. A station on the backside for mark one. Station out here. I'm not sure where we're going to put the person to plant these blind on the second finger or the first finger, but we'll figure that out somehow.
We did talk about it. We don't want them hot.
Do what?
We don't want them hot.
No, I wouldn't put them hot.
One
although that one should be okay.
Yes.
Yeah, I don't think it's
from would. The cover to the back shore.
From the first?
No, second from the,
second.
You see our longer blind?
Mm-hmm, that one.
A little piece of cover that comes out and it sort of ends.
Uh-huh.
We'll put a holding blind there, and throwing back. It at a good angle back into the grass.
Oh, okay. Yesterday we threw it from.
Gotcha. Okay.
No, we threw it from back there yesterday.
Did we? I thought we threw it from this.
Nope. No. Nope.
From the middle point back.
Well, you ran us yesterday?
I did, yeah. Mm. That's why Hero's not here. He failed miserably. He's out of the post.
Oh, you want to look good on the video.
Yeah.
Back from your last bird mark, you'll throw the diversion, no off and run that blind because I'm convinced it's a crippled bird. I want it picked up. I'm convinced because I saw it run all the way from there after this place.
Did you?
Yes.
They knew exactly where to go.
It's amazing how they do the same thing every time. Why is the middle mark not going to be a problem?
Oh, it's going to be a problem.
Because they just have to keep going.
Got to keep on keeping on.
Keep on going.
The big problem here is how many times dogs break down on that first point. They'll break down and hunt.
Yeah.
Because again, from a dog's perspective, at their level, it looks like it could be laying on that first finger. They don't see the water. So that's sort of a surprise when they hit there and cause them to hit the brake. But again, in training, you want them to persevere and go on through that. So, you know, if you're training, don't set up on the first point. Always go to the second if you get that opportunity. Now, once you've got them doing that, then you start making them check down on it, because you want them to be able to do both. You don't want to, every time you come to a re-entry level, blow on through. So this is one that takes a train. You have to see it enough to have confidence to go on through, but so also to be willing to break down if you have to. That makes absolutely no sense on that. But
yeah, how are they supposed to figure that out?
Experience. Yeah. Just like this duck knows where to run and duck. Okay, here we go. Here? Good, here? No.
Good girl. Back. No. Here.
test you back at home. August test here.
Does he have it? No, no, sit down, leave it, leave it, here, sit, sit, no, okay, sit, get her, I don't know, leave it, sit, sit, get her,
Thank you. Yeah, one more bird. Give.
Yes, I remember it.
Pearl. Here. Pearl. Pearl. Here. Back up. Here, eel.
probably most everybody's here. What you think of this?
Well, who is a ball buster?
There was somebody to put in play here. Maybe a little more challenge. I think wind came into play here. I guess down across the place that came to Florida. That's always something you want to think of. If you're running across the board like that. Good folks and dogs make that pass. We saw a little bit of that. Earlier, when the bird was thrown behind this fence and cover, again, that's like a great wall there. The dogs had some of them thrown on the ocean. Using cover like that.
A few notes on the left hand direction. Just on the inside where the board was in. We had a pretty nice wind guard out. Quarter chase. From the middle board, you had the re-entry. But I think we're the major. Major things that affected most of these dogs was that cover strip on the point. They flared that, especially when they flared it in the lap. They lost their line and got a little bit lost. I think that hurt them. And some dogs just, need a little bit more hard work on doing that kind of re-entry, They did just see the carpet, they didn't see the water surprise on the other side. They did that normal young dog thing, they chiseled up about the point. The flyer was a pretty good flyer because it was out in a flat, nondescript area, they could easily overrun it. It was exciting for them. Dogs marked up the right hand line, they had the pit problem, the guy at the first point, put the road to the left, And most of the time when you get a dog in a point like that, you gotta try to demand. 45-3 off the point as a new one's training thing, so you avoid doing. They get in the habit of coming at a 45 off the point as opposed to going straight over and looking around the corner. So if you have left line, if they went into the cover to the left, they had a tendency to hook to the left. Feed it to the right, they had a tendency to go right to the right, so that line was pretty much just staying there and staying on course and a piece of water. It had suction probably more so from the flyer, but also suction from the driver's guy deep there.
And a little diversion boat for a lot of professional dogs trying to run that line. We ran this yesterday. I do this enough that my dogs came in, they didn't even look to the diversion motor. They lined up looking for wherever the blind is going to be. So, you just do enough of that, put it in your training package, and the dogs will adapt to that pretty easily. But if they don't see that, you're going to see exactly what we did. Today, dogs really fighting and want to get over there.
And you can train that just by throwing an interrupted triple, so you don't throw triples all the time. You can throw two birds down, pick one up, maybe run a blind, throw another bird down, pick it up, pick up a second bird, the first two you threw up.
Yeah, interrupted barks is a good, again, a really good training tool. you can incorporate and do a lot of things with that. And it just teaches your dogs that, you know, they need to respond to you, not just doing what they think they're supposed to do. So that's a really good point.
I know everybody does it, and I have a really hard time keeping myself from doing it. If you're having, you know, some difficulty handling your dog, let's just say you're casting to the left, everybody has a tendency to walk to the left. And when you're doing that, the farther you get to the left, the harder it is for that dog to take that cast you want, because, you know, you think about the geometry to it, you're making it harder and harder for the dog to take that literal cast. You really got to try to stay in the same place, you know, stay where you originated from, run you from. I know it's hard to do. I catch myself doing it all the time.
And one of the reasons for that is the judge is probably still sitting in the exact same place, and that line you're suddenly running from way over here to that blind is maybe a little different line than what the judge is sitting here wanting to see.
You go watch field trials, those guys are religious about it. Sometimes they'll take a big walking cast, and when the dog turns to take the cast, they immediately come back to the man.
I believe this will be the place for comments and questions.
From the side
of
the
yeah.
Everybody maybe is being roasted.
Roasted fire.
You know, when you go out to train with your buddies and somebody sets something up pretty big, instead of just trying to run it with the dog, if you don't think it's quite that level yet, like that man you bird, walk way up on it.
Yeah.
Have them throw that bird for the dog, mm-hmm. And then back up to maybe where they're running from and run it again. The dog will develop some learning.
I don't know that. If you're having trouble with that, take your dog over on the first point and run that time or two. Then come back over to here and run it. You can teach your dogs about, you know, taking that re-entry.
Also, when they're young dogs, you got people helping you. I'm sure you've all heard that term, fire driller. You know, you can throw multiple marks when the dog's in, right?